Hey there everybody, Eric Merced here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I want to do an explanation of how to use my comic book page templates for Procreate. So I went ahead and created a couple of templates that I use when I'm creating comic books in Procreate. And I wanted to go through some of the things that are included in these templates and do kind of like a walkthrough and explanation of what everything is, how to use it, and basically how I use them and how you can take advantage of these templates. I also want to mention that these templates are available on my Gumroad store, and they are completely free. So I'm gonna look at two of the templates today. I'm gonna look at the comic page template, and I'm gonna look at the comic thumbnail template. And by looking at those, I'm going to give you an example of how I set it up, the logic behind setting it up the way that I set it up, and basically how I use them when I'm creating comics inside of Procreate with these templates. All right, so let's get into it. All right, so let's open up the comic page template and let's take a look at how that is set up inside of Procreate. So the first thing you're going to notice when you open this template up is that you have a couple of lines in blue that are basically guidelines. So if you're new to comics, this is going to be kind of like a crash course in what these lines are meant to represent. And if you're familiar with this, you can probably skip ahead. Zooming in here, you're going to see that they're labeled as live area, and the outer dotted one is called the trim area. So I'm going to do my best to explain what these lines represent. So the live area, which is this area right here, and basically it's anything within this solid blue line right here that you're seeing. This is where all of your important artwork and all of your letters, you know, your word balloons, your captions, this is where everything is going to be contained within. So basically, when you look at a comic book page, you're looking at the page, right? We're talking about the printed comic book page. And usually, typically, the comic book page consists of the artwork, which is contained in the center. So all of your panels or frames and all the lettering, all the artwork is contained within that center. And then you have just white all over. So anything in that center on a printed page is contained within the live area. So the thing to remember about using the live area is that you want to keep all of your important artwork and all of your type, which means your word balloons, your captions, all within this area. So basically all of your panels can come up against the border, but typically you can go beyond the border with your panels, which we'll get into that right in a couple of minutes. But for a typically normal comic book page, you want to contain all of your artwork within this live area. So that brings us to the trim area, which is this area right here. And it's in this comic book template, it's denoted by these dotted lines. So if you want to do like a splash page or a page where the art extends to the very edges of the page, it's okay for you to draw beyond the live area into the trim area and even beyond the trim area. You can do that. You can draw here and here. So basically you can fill the entire page with artwork so that when it's printed into the comic book, your artwork will extend to the edge of the page, and basically you won't see any borders or anything. You can do that. But the reason the trim area is here is because the trim area is basically going to let you know you can draw here within the live area, you can extend your artwork out to the trim area, which is this area here, and you can even extend your artwork beyond the trim area, which is this area here, basically above the dotted lines. But what's going to happen is when the time comes to get this page ready for printing into a comic book, anything that extends beyond the trim area is going to be trimmed out. It's going to be cut out. That's why it's called the trim area. So keep in mind that anything in this area here, anything beyond the trim area, is going to possibly be cut off to get the page down to the standard American comic book size. So anything within this area and anything within this area will be printed, will most likely be printed. But anything beyond the trim area, which is this area here where I'm scribbling on, will be most likely trimmed out. It's that simple. That's why you don't want to put your word balloons here, or you don't want to put your word balloons here. You want to keep your word balloons somewhere within the live area. Because if you put your word balloon here, for example, like here, this whole area here is going to be trimmed out, and you're only going to get half of your balloon and half of your type showing. And you don't want to really extend your balloons beyond the live area, because there's always a danger of anything in this area getting cut off depending on the printer. So always keep your important artwork within the live area. You can extend your artwork up to the trim area line, but anything beyond the trim area is basically going to get cut out. All right, now that we've looked at the guides, let's go ahead and take a look at how I've set up all of the layers within this file to help you have a better workflow when you're working inside of Procreate with these templates. You're gonna see we have a couple of layers that I've already set up for you. We have the crop marks, which is basically just those blue lines there. We have a layer called blue line. I'll explain what that is pretty soon. We have a sketch, pencil, ink art, panels, balloons plus captions, and a letters layer. Let's look at the sketch layer. The sketch layer is basically where it's self-explanatory, where you're gonna do your sketch. So you're gonna do your, say, your breakdowns here, or the sketch for the page here, or the sketch for the pinup or whatever. You're gonna do it in this layer called sketch. If you need to add another layer, you just go ahead and add another layer, right? And you add whatever other element you're gonna add to it. And then if you wanna keep these layers intact, you can always merge down to the sketch layer. So once you're done with that sketch, you're gonna wanna refine it. That's where the pencils layer comes in, right? Everybody works differently, but I've set this up more or less kind of like how maybe the majority of the people work. They'll first start out with a sketch, then they'll wanna refine the pencils, and then they'll want to go into the ink art. So what I would do when I'm done with the sketch and I wanna refine them in the pencil stage, I will take the sketch layer, and this is where the blue line layer comes in handy, and I will drag the sketch layer below the blue line. Now, the blue line layer is basically a layer that's filled with blue, and it's set to screen. So if we open this up, you're gonna see that it's set to screen, and it's set to 100% opacity. Basically, that's turning your pencil, your sketch into blue line. So that way I can go into the pencils and I can start refining that drawing and adding the details that I need to add and making the drawing much better. Now, again, the same process repeats. When I'm done with my pencils and I wanna jump into inking, I will turn off the sketch layer or delete it, whatever you wanna do, and then drag the pencils below the blue. And then I will be able to go to the ink art layer, and I'll be able to ink my artwork. Okay, so now that we've taken a look at what the blue line layer and the sketch and pencils and ink art layers are used, let's take a look at the panels layer. So the panels layer, basically self-explanatory, is going to be where you're going to draw your panel borders. That is basically the black borders that you're going to draw your art within. So there are several ways you can do this. You can basically draw these borders out by hand and then just go ahead and have Procreate as you hold this. You can use the shape tools in Procreate and then shape these out to fit more or less, you know, inside the border. Now, that's one way you can do it. But there is a much easier way, a way that I highly recommend you to do this. So let's get rid of this and let me show you how I draw my borders out. So again, we're in the panels layer, and we're going to do all of our panels within this layer. So in order to do this, it's a very simple method. I'm going to go into my Actions tab and go to Canvas, and I'm going to turn on Drawing Guide. Now, your drawing guide might be in perspective, or it might be in something else. So I'm going to hit Edit Drawing Guide and make sure that I'm in 2D grid. I just leave it as default, but I'll make sure that I turn Assisted Drawing on. Now with assisted drawing on, all I've got to do is just freely draw my borders. So let's say we have one long border at the top. You can see how easy this becomes using assisted drawing. You don't have to struggle. All you've got to do is just draw your lines for your borders. And you do this throughout. You just draw all your borders using assisted drawing with a 2D grid, and it'll be easier. You don't have to worry about making sure that your lines are straight or they're you know, butting against the borders or anything, because assisted drawing will basically help you draw the lines the way you need to draw them. So next is balloons and captions, which is self-explanatory. You can do your balloons and your captions within this layer. And then I have also added a letters layer. So it's basically just a text layer with the default text in it. And you can just go ahead and tap on the text and choose edit style, and choose the and just use the font that you want to use for your comic book. Now, my advice is that once you create the size and you choose the font that you want to use, always duplicate your layers. So, for example, if we tap on this layer and let's choose Anime Ace 3. And let's give it a size of, just for visibility, let's just leave it at 25. And then I'll type in here something like so. So that will be my first dialogue right there. Now, instead of going ahead and repeating and doing a new type layer and retyping everything, I'm just going to go ahead and hit duplicate and move this over to whatever frame I need it to be, and then I'll just double tap here and type my new dialogue in there. And basically I'll just do a repeat of that. So the downside of doing this is that you're going to end up with a lot of type layers. But that is really not, the template is not at fault here. Really, it's just the way that Procreate at the moment works. It doesn't allow you to take a ton of type and contain it within one layer. And if you merge these downs, unfortunately, you're going to get them rasterized to the point that you won't be able to edit them later. But you can do that. You can keep maybe one layer as your default type layer and then rasterize all of the layers into a single layer when you're done with your type. And it'll be easier if you ever have to go in and re-edit anything. You can use your default type layer to edit whatever it is that you have to edit and erase whatever is rasterized and replace it with the edited type. So that's pretty much how the layers are set up in the comic book template. They're all set up to kind of help you stay organized and move a little quicker. And again, like I said, these templates are completely free. Just go to Gumroad and download them. I'm gonna leave a link in the video description below. Let's go ahead and move on to the other template that I wanna cover, which is the thumbnails template. Okay, so now we're gonna take a look at the comic thumbnail template. So, opening this up, we're going to, first of all, let me clear this out. We're going to find that we have four thumbnails for representing four pages. If we zoom in here, we're going to see that these represent basically four pages. It has the page number there that you can add to it. And there, this template allows you to do four pages at a time. And if we turn this layer on, you'll see that I've added some of my thumbnails from my Kenobi Star Wars fan comic. So what I've done is with this template, I've simplified it. You just have your template layer and you have a single empty layer on the top. I've pretty much simplified this. I didn't add too many layers to this. This gives you the freedom to just use as many layers as you need to use to get your thumbnails done with this template. So as you can see, I have four pages that I thumbnailed, and I've thumbnailed them all within this template. So now what do I do with this? So simply what I would do next is basically I would choose my selection tool. I'll make sure that it's set to rectangle. And let's say I want to take that first thumbnail and put it into a page, and that's going to be my first page. So I'll just select that first thumbnail. And then I'll choose copy. And I'll get out of there and I'll go back to the comic page template. And then I will make sure that I'm on the sketch layer because this is my thumbnail. And then I will swipe down and choose paste. Now to make this quick, I'm going to go and hit fit to screen. And that'll make the thumbnail large enough to fit the whole page. And then all I've got to do from there on is just pretty much downsize the thumbnail to more or less fit the area, the live area, like so. And now that my thumbnails is pasted into the sketch layer, I can actually take that sketch layer and drag it down into the blue line layer and work on refining the pencils. Very simple, very easy. These templates are meant to save you a ton of time, and they're meant to just get you going, just get you drawing, and just get you creating. So that's it. That's pretty simple. That's pretty easy. I hope you guys have enjoyed this explainer video, and I hope you guys will go ahead and grab those templates. Again, they're free. I don't have any intentions of making them a for-pay download. Again, you can download them for free, or if you feel inclined to do so and you want to bless me and you want to give $1, $2, or whatever you want to give for the templates, feel free to do so. Every little bit helps. But overall, these templates are free for you to download right now in Gumroad. They will only work in Procreate. I haven't made Photoshop versions of them, so they will only work in Procreate. So if you've got any questions, leave them in the comments below. And I'll try to get back to you as soon as I can. And I hope you guys are staying safe and being creative in these trying times. And hopefully you guys will enjoy these templates, and hopefully you guys will have enjoyed this video. I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, peace and God bless you all. Bye.